was on the cross, I was on his mind. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for such love, Lord. Thank you. Brother Paul, would you be kind to open us in prayer, brother? Thank you. Yes, Lord Jesus, thank you. Yes, Lord.
Thank you, Lord, God, for all that you've done for us.
Thank you, Lord.
Forgive us, Lord, for taking you for granted and things you've done for us tonight. Forgive us, Lord, for our shortcomings. Help us, Lord, to become strong.
Yes.
Be faithful servants of your word.
Thank you, Lord.
Bless your word as it comes forth today, Lord. We ask this in Jesus Christ's name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Brother Paul. God
bless you. Amen.
Welcome, Brother Joshua. And brethren, let's turn to number 43 and let's sing that lovely hymn. Thou art worthy and hast loosed the seal.
Amen.
Amen. We are one group of people who can sing this hymn.
Yes, amen.
With passion and conviction. Hallelujah.
Show me.
this service into your hands.
Thank you, Father.
We thank you, Almighty God, that we have the opportunity of once again gathering in the name of your Son,
amen,
the Lord Jesus
thank
Christ.
You,
we pray this morning that the Holy Spirit would quicken your word to our hearts. As we reminisce and go over the things stated by the seventh angel, the messenger of Malachi 4, we pray that you would give us enlightenment this day. We'll give you all the praise and the glory and the honor. We ask it in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Oh, while we're standing, let's just have a look at the scripture reading this day. You know, we're dealing with and have been dealing with the mystery, invisible union of the bride.
Amen.
And every Sunday we come together to delve into the invisible. We sing about the invisible.
Yes.
We read about the invisible.
Amen.
We believe in the invisible. We praise and worship him who is invisible.
Yes.
The only true God. And let us take the scripture reading and then you will be seated. Romans 10, 14 to 17. How then shall they call on him in whom they have not believed? And how shall they believe in him whom they have not heard? And how shall they hear without a preacher? And how shall they preach except they be sent? As it is written, how beautiful are the feet of them that preach the gospel of peace and bring glad tidings and good things. But they have not all obeyed the gospel, for Isaiah saith, Lord, who hath believed our report?
Yes.
So then faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God.
Amen.
God bless you, you. May be seated. On the front of your book, we have a new portion added to this study that we're looking at. And it is quoting the statements of Brother Branham. He said, I knelt down to pray and raised up my hands, and a sword struck my hand. Now this is a phenomenal thing. This is something you're either going to believe or you're not going to believe.
True.
But he said it happened. And then he said the angel of the Lord revealed it. It was the word in the hand. The word had come down into the hand of the seventh angel. And here is a very important utterance of the prophet. He said, when this seventh angel rises in the Laodicean age and begins to sound forth the true trumpet, because it will be contrary, they won't believe it.
That's right. Yeah.
They won't believe it. It's good to see Brother Joshua back in the meeting. The last time I saw him, he was off to Singapore. Did you go back to Singapore? No. Okay. It's too good for him here for him to go back, I think. And we had a conversation last time I saw him. And he said the third pool. I spoke about it last week. How that he said the third pool. Why would it be so hard to understand the third pool? The first pool and the second pool, that That was very easy to understand. When it came to the third pool, many people scratched their head because it wasn't a public shop.
That's right.
And it was met with massive unbelief. And I said to him, I said, it wasn't God that made the third pool so hard. It was man himself that made the third pool hard. Because he's so entangled with his wisdom. Now, we're going to get into that in the next study. We've got two more messages on this, and then we're going into this third pool and why it is so misunderstood. But the last messenger, in dealing with the word and teaching the word, he said that the seventh angel, when he comes on the scene, his message is going to be completely different to what the churches have taught.
That's right.
Because now the seals are up. And our conclusion over the years of studying the message of the seventh angel, we know that is true. It's very hard for anybody that believes the seventh angel to explain the message to somebody else. You know, we've got to come to the fact that it is inexplainable. Because it's revealed truth. And you can't explain a revelation. You can't do it. This seventh angel was placed on earth and he had a mission. And we know that that mission was to forerun the second coming of Christ. We know that. And so, we're going to read a number of quotes. Now, in these messages, in these last three messages pertaining to this subject, I will be referring to a number of quotes that Brother Steve Ellison sent. Quotes that we've read, but I believe we need to reread.
Yes, amen.
And the more you read them, the more you understand.
Amen.
Brother Bram spoke about a quote the other day, or a statement, and he said, we've said it many times, but we haven't yet caught the real meaning of it. And he said, I would like to reiterate, I would like to go over the seals again. I'd like to go over this again so that we may grasp it.
Yes.
Go back and read it again.
True.
And here he made a tremendous statement in the first quote we're going to read. He said, now I'm just your brother by the grace of God. But when the angel of the Lord moves down, it becomes then a voice of God to you.
Yeah.
And if I have offended you for saying that, forgive me. But I felt that it might be resented. But I am God's voice to you, see? I say that again. That time was under inspiration, see? I felt bad about the first time, but it repeated.
Amen.
And we need to repeat and go over many of the things that he said. Because it's God's voice speaking to us. A familiar portion of the message is found in the Laodicean age. He explains this messenger that we have come together this morning to meditate upon his words. He said, now this messenger of Malachi 4 in Revelation 10:7 is going to do two things. One, according to Malachi 4, he will, amen, turn the hearts of the children to the fathers.
Yes.
Two, he will reveal the mysteries of the seven thunders of Revelation 10.
Amen.
Are you listening? Which are the revelations contained in the seven seals?
Yes. Amen.
It will be these divinely revealed mystery truths that literally turn our hearts, or turn the hearts of the children, to the Pentecostal fathers, even so.
Praise God. Amen.
Now let us be careful here. Here was a man who was in prayer and a sword fell into his hand. And later, the angel revealed it was the word. Now, you can believe Moses knelt down before the burning bush. That's easy to believe. You read it in the Word. You've seen the Ten Commandments. Man has visualized it. You can get it in your mind and you can understand it. And there are pictures after pictures after pictures of Moses at the burning bush. Yes, I believe it, Brother Ashley. I believe that there was a bush right before Moses that was on fire and never was consumed. I believe that. Then why can't you believe a sword coming to the hands of the seventh angel?
True. Amen.
See? Our hearts are going to be affected, brother, by this message. And how we respond to this message will determine your eternal destination.
Yeah.
The truth. So let us read some of these amazing things that he said. His message now will be difficult to understand. Not only that, but in number two it says, many, are you reading with me now? Many will misunderstand him because they have been taught scripture in a certain way which they consider truth. From a little child they grow up and they are taught certain things in Sunday school. They are taught certain things from their ministers. But when the seventh angel comes on the scene, he's going to be contrary to denominational teaching.
That's right. Amen.
And because he is contrary to what they've been taught, they find it extremely hard to believe. You see, if you never heard all those stories, it would be a different story.
True.
But because you have heard those stories, it makes the real story hard to understand. When he comes against that, they will not believe. Even, look at this one. Even some true ministers, they're out there, will misunderstand the messenger. See? Because so much has been called God's truth by deceit. When he comes against the doctrine of Trinity, they won't believe because they've been taught in another way. When he comes against the rapture doctrine and brings the real truth of the rapture, they stumble and fall all over the place. Too hard to believe. When he says speaking in tongues, is not the evidence of the Holy Ghost? The Pentecostals shake their head and say, that's too hard to believe. When he says all your denominational outfit is of the devil, oh, that stumbles. How dare you say such a thing as that? But he said, it's thus saith the Lord. Amen. Serpent seed. See, all these things, they won't believe. But here he comes, number three. First of all, that messenger is going to be a prophet. He's going to be a prophet.
Yes.
And people who don't know what a prophet is, turn their back and walk away. Don't do it, brother. A prophet is the mouthpiece of God.
Amen.
He will have the office of a prophet. He will have the prophetic ministry. It will be based solidly on the word, because when he prophesies or has a vision, it will always be word-oriented. As it will always come to pass, he will be vindicated as a prophet because of his accuracy. The proof that he is a prophet is found in Revelation 10. See, you've got all those evidences, and then on top of it, you've got the scripture identifying him. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God shall be finished, as he has declared unto his servants the prophets. Now we have a great big title. Smorgasbord before us this morning. Quote after quote after quote after quote.
Amen.
Take these quotes, treasure them.
Yeah.
Look at them, believe them, study them, meditate upon them. The sword of the king, number four. And he took the book, glory, opened the book, tore off the seals. The seals are now up. The mystery is being revealed.
Amen.
He tore the book open. He tore off the seals. And what did he do? Oh, hallelujah, can you receive it? And sent it down to the earth to his seventh angel to reveal it to his people.
Amen.
There you are.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Amen. Where was the word placed? In the hands of the seventh angel.
Yes.
He was the instrument God used to reveal the mysteries to his children.
That's right.
Number five, look. I went up in the canyon, climbed up, where the eagles were flying around. Oh, what territory he was moving in.
Yes.
I knelt down and prayed and raised my hands, and a sword struck my hand, and I heard a voice say, that's the king's sword. Amen. I said, a knight, a king knights a man with a sword. He, the voice, come back and said, not a king's sword, but the king's sword, the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Said, fear not. It's only the third pool. It's the vindication of your ministry. Now, how many people have walked along and gone along with the message until they come to this, and then they stop and get off the train? They turn their back and they walk away. They abandon the whole thing because they say it's too hard to understand. It's true. forsake the word of the Lord. And they turn away from the most sublime thing in Holy Writ. Oh my. Number six. The sword of the king. This is the sword of the king. And then later, when the angel of the Lord revealed it, it was the word in the hand.
Amen.
Oh, praise God.
Yes.
Hallelujah! He had the word in the hand, and he was commissioned to drop it into the hearts of the predestinated.
That's right.
Well, yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
It had to be deposited into the hearts of the children. God dropped the entire mysteries of the word into the hands of the seventh angel. And he ministered these mysteries into the hearts of the children. Number seven, yes, listen to this authenticated prophet who appears in the last age. There he is. There's a picture of him with the pillar of fire.
Amen.
What he says from God, the bride will say. The Spirit and the prophet and the bride will be saying the same thing.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
And what they say, you listen, will have already been said in the Word.
Amen.
Number eight, now if you're spiritual, you'll catch something. Why was he the greatest of all other prophets and spoken by the Messiah? But John introduced him. Have you caught something?
Yes.
He was the one that presented him. So will it be in the end time.
Amen.
Everything's running according to schedule. Don't be offended. Listen, just believe.
Amen.
Only believe.
Amen.
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 You can't understand it? Believe it.
Amen.
You can't figure it out? Just believe it. Amen.
Amen.
Let the heathen rage, brother. Let the message people repudiate and condemn and say what they want to. Just believe. That's all. Just believe. Number nine. Watch carefully now. Be careful. Malachi 4 has not yet been fulfilled. But it must be fulfilled, for it is a germatized word of God spoken through Malachi the prophet. Jesus referred to it. It's just to be before the coming of Christ the second time. Listen close now. Are you listening? Are you listening? The Gentile dispensation is to be finished with the church ages when this anointed messenger arrives.
Yes. Amen.
Where are you now? It's all over.
Yep.
We're way down the road, brother.
Yep.
All scripture has been fulfilled that surrounded Malachi 4.
Yes.
It's finished. The seventh angel wraps up the whole thing and brings the world to the consummation.
Yes.
Number 10, we told in the last days, that will repeat again. There's going to be a message, see that? That'll come forth, that'll introduce the Messiah to the people.
Amen.
Have you heard the message? Have you received it? It's out there, brother.
That's right.
Amen. And it's not only out there, it's right here before you this day. What is the message? The Lord be in such a way that they'll stand dumbfounded like it was there. Dumbfounded. The clergy, the theologians, the ministers, the preachers. See, the message groups, the Methodists, the Baptists, the Presbyterians, the whole lot will be dumbfounded at this message that sweeps through the church.
Yes.
Dumbfounded means astonished, astounded, amazed, staggered, surprised, startled, stunned, and confounded. What's the message? Number 11. In the seventh watch he comes. There it is. And that's the seventh church age. That's the seventh angel's message. What is it? In the seventh watch he comes.
Yes.
The seventh watch is over.
That's true.
It's done.
Amen.
The church ages are finished. Just look out there, bro. Where are the revivals? Where are the altar calls? These people are going to be left totally dumbfounded. Number 12a. Now I want you to be very careful. Hear and see this. God has promised that at the end time, Malachi 4 is going to be fulfilled. It has to be, for it is spirit quickened word of God spoken by the prophet Malachi. Jesus referred to it. It's just before the coming of Christ the second time. By the time Jesus comes, all scripture must be fulfilled. Let's read that properly. All scripture must be fulfilled that pertain to Malachi 4:5. Just believe, he said, everything is now history. Number 12b, the Gentile dispensation will be in a last church age. When the messenger of Malachi comes, he will be right with the word. He will take the whole Bible from Genesis to Revelation. He will start at serpent seed and carry on to the messenger of the latter day. But he will be rejected by the denominations. They won't ever borrow. No. Denominations flatly reject the seventh angel's message. Because it's contrary. It's contrary. And they won't believe. They sure won't believe. Number 13, you just sung it. The seals has been opened.
Yes.
That proves what they've left out of the church age. And the message, listening, has been given.
Amen.
It's over.
Yeah.
Israel is on the scene, hallelujah, ready for the Feast of the Trumpets. Brother, sister, we are way down the road. We're in a terrible hour. A dangerous time. Number 14, Revelation 10 is the seventh angel's message. And what is Revelation 10? Saw another mighty angel come down from heaven.
Yes.
So clothed in a cloud and a rainbow was upon his head.
Yes. Amen.
Revelation 10 is the seventh angel's message, the seventh angel, the seventh church age, which is Malachi 4. Elijah the prophet stepped out of Malachi 4, brought the Gentiles back to the word. Now, because of rejection, they face the consummation. What's left?
The atomic bomb.
Obra. Number 15, can you accept this? Can you believe it with all your heart? When that seventh angel sounds out, every mystery is over.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let him be who he may, whatever it might be. God's word cannot fail.
True.
He will turn the hearts of the children back to the fathers, and he will reveal the mysteries that are contained in the seventh seal.
Yes.
Did he do it?
Hallelujah. Amen.
Is it now
complete?
Yes.
Has the message been given?
Yes.
You say amen, 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 and the Lord has come.
Yes, amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh, it does us good to come along on a Sunday,
yes,
and read these quotes. It just refreshes us and builds us up.
Yes.
Number 17, he promised in Luke 17:30 that this same Son of Man, he promised it, would be revealed in the days like it was in Sodom upon the earth. Did he do it?
Oh, my.
16. Here we go. 16 is the most important one. And we do have today, by God's help, perfect interpretation of the word with divine vindication.
Hallelujah. Thank
Do we
you.
Have it?
Yes, we've got it.
Amen.
Amen.
Do we have it in this hall? Yes, we have it in this
Amen.
Hall. Does everybody believe it in the hall? Well, only God knows that. Amen. Number 18. The reason people in Noah's day did not go into the ark, because they never recognized the message, nor the messenger. That's the only reason they perished, is because they didn't recognize the hour they were living in.
That's right.
Oh my. See, it's blasted out before you, brother. It's hanging out there before you, sister. Do you believe the hour you were living in? As it was in the days of Sodom, so shall it be. Don't be disturbed when you see all this news. It's modern events being made clear by prophecy.
Yes.
Jesus said, as it was in the days of Noah. We're going to cut into the days of Noah. I've got another set of messages coming up. See? Brother, we haven't even touched half of the truth that lay in the days of Noah.
That's right.
We have iconic signs before us. We have so much to dig into. Number 19. God had ordained a certain thing to be done, and it must be done that way. We're not to inject our own ideas. See, that's where the problem comes. We're to respect his idea and his commandment.
That's right.
And his commandment is what? Believe his prophets, so shall ye prosper.
Amen.
Amen.
That's God's way of doing it. Don't run to your pastor now. Don't come to me. Believe his prophet.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Oh, here we go. Number 20. Listen to every word. Catch it. Not only catch it, wait.
Amen.
Yes.
And don't make this mistake. Don't say nothing but what the tapes say. the lips of his prophet.
Yes.
Therefore, he could say, I am God's voice to you.
That's right.
Oh, my, there's strict advice there.
Yes.
Amen. Here comes a super quote. Listen to every word now. And catch it. Catch it, don't let it go. If it gets away from you, pull it back. Say, wait a minute, I wanna go over this again and again and again. Number 21, just as John was giving his message the same time that the Messiah came in the days, John knew he would see him because he was going to introduce him.
Yes.
Yes, I accept that, Brother Ashley. I've read that in the Bible. I believe that. Brother, message believer, whoever you might be, there's more to this quote than just that.
That's right.
Let's read it finished.
Amen.
Let's say all that he said in this quote.
Yes.
And we realize, hallelujah, that in the scriptures, only Malachi 4, amen. There's to be one like John and Elijah.
Amen.
Behold, I send unto you Elijah, the prophet.
Yes.
Say what he says. Don't say anything else. John waded his way through the Jews, remember? And they rejected him. He chopped his head off. They didn't want anything to do with his new style of preaching. He was contrary to the scribes and the Pharisees anyway. He never went to any of their synagogues. He stayed his distance. Well, I believe that. I can understand. I've got the picture of John the Baptist. Well, get the picture of Elijah the prophet in the last days.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
He waded his way through the Gentiles. Listen to number 22. When the angel of the Lord come down and said, go to Tucson. You'll be northeast of Tucson. And there'll come seven angels in a cluster that will shake the whole earth around you. And said it'll be told you from there. So he went. He went west as commanded. And he said, I was in Sabina Canyon one morning, which is just north of Tucson, and something struck my hand.
Yes, yes.
And it was revealed by the angel of the Lord. It was the Word.
Amen.
So why not believe it? Amen. If you don't believe it, why waste your time coming to the church service? And in Sabina Canyon, he said, this is the third pool.
Amen.
Number 23. Said the seven seals are the hidden mysteries of the entire Bible. Did you get that? Would be opened, hallelujah, and fulfilled. Revelations 10.
Yes.
Whoa, can you say amen?
Amen.
That in the seventh angel's message, these things should come to pass. Amen.
Yes.
This day, this scripture is fulfilled before our eyes.
Yes.
This day, this scripture is fulfilled. 1965, his message to the earth, his mission to the earth had been fulfilled.
the message had been given. It had been accomplished. Now the Gentiles have to deal with it. It caused them to go into confusion. Along come 300 ministers from the denominations. They said, hey, that Brother Branham, he's really straight down the line on the word. We believe him. We're coming to be baptized, rebaptized according to the scriptures. Did they come? They dealt with it. They made their decision. Have you dealt with it? Have you made your decision? Will you believe him? Or are you going to believe some minister behind the pulpit? Some genius, some educated dude with a bow tie? I don't like them. I don't like the preachers. And the preachers don't like me. Because I believe in saying exactly what the tapes say.
Yes.
We send out the little booklet every week. And in there are the utterances of the seventh angel.
Yes.
Some people look at it and throw it aside. Other people take it, read it, say, oh, amen, this is food to my soul.
Yes.
Brother David Hawkins in the United States of America rejoices every week as he hears the statements read of the seventh angel.
Yeah.
So does Brother Edward in Indonesia. One here, one there, one on the other side of the earth,
yes,
in accordance to what the prophet of God said.
Right.
Amen. Oh, what an hour we're living in. The entire Bible would be opened and fulfill Revelation 10. That in the seventh angel's message, these things should come to pass. This day, this scripture has been fulfilled.
Yeah.
Number 24, in the seventh hour, the seventh messenger, that all these mysteries should be finished. See, the seventh earthly messenger, see, this angel that he speaks of then was on earth.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Here he is.
Yes.
The Gentiles have to deal with his message. Many, many will misunderstand him because they have been taught scripture in a certain way that they consider truth. Oh my.
Yes.
My, my, my. Look how difficult it is to come to terms with the seventh angel's message. Look at number 25. Now how he said it will appear in the last days is to bring the people back to the word. So the bride will know her husband, her mate. The revealed word. That's why this had to happen. It wasn't in the reformers. It wasn't in Luther, Wesley, and the Pentecostals and them. The scripture says it wasn't, but it will come, hallelujah. That is the promise for this age. We're living in the age that his coming will be in.
Yes, amen.
Oh, how that went right over the heads of the people, and they're still looking for his coming. Amen.
Yes.
That was said in the 21st century or the 20th century. We're now in the 21st century.
Yes.
He sent a prophet.
His mission was to forerun the coming of the Lord. And he did it. God detailed it perfectly by prophetic utterance. And even signs took the picture.
True.
Amen.
Amen.
Oh, what a picture.
Yeah.
What a picture. It happened late in the 20th century. You know, we have almost over 300 little booklets with quote after quote after quote nailing the second coming of Christ. It's gone out. Who knows where these booklets are in the world today? But they've gone forth. Amen. Detailing, unveiling the most sublime thing in Holy Writ. Number 26. The messenger is here now, which is Jesus Christ. The Bible said so. He never does anything but first makes it known to his prophets. Amos 3:7. He always has done it. He never changes his pattern. True. Amen. Number 27. I hope and trust that you have a spiritual understanding of what that God has been trying to get over to the church without saying it right out.
True, brother. Amen.
See, it's got to come another way. It's got to come by faith and revelation. See, it's the thing sometimes we have to say things in such a way that it might thin down. It might bring some to go out, some to leave, and some to ponder. But that's done purposely. It must be done that way.
Yes, amen.
Under those conditions, only the elect of God will be able to discern the truth. Amen. They'll be the only ones that will be able to pick it up. Notice number 28. Notice Revelations 10, 1-7. All the mysteries are to be revealed to the bride by the messenger of the Laodicean church. It's got to happen. And it has happened. Don't look for it to happen. He said, this day this scripture has been fulfilled. Number 29. Wait till the seven thunders utter their voices. To that group who can really take the word of God and hand it there. It'll slice and cut. See, the word that was placed in the hands of the seventh angel has to be placed in the hands of the predestinated bride. Amen. For she will be saying the same thing he said.
Yes.
She will be the final voice to the final age. Number 30, Christ has a sharp sword and watch. It comes from his mouth, the living word. Number 31, notice Revelations 10, 1-7. All the mysteries are to be revealed to the bride by the messenger of the Laodicean church. Number 32, he. Oh, look at this one. He is making a bride. Yes, sir. All has to be cut away from the church. Not some things now. All things. All has to be cut away from the church. Their formal ideas, their indifference, their doctrines and things. He is cutting you out now, cutting you down to his word only. Amen. Cutting all the creeds and dogmas and everything away from you. Trying to get you back as a bride for a son. Another masterpiece. Part of the word. the Word.
Amen.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen and amen. He is making a bride.
True.
He is the author and finisher of our faith.
Amen.
Amen. A voice spoke out. It said, this is the sword of the Lord. Why, if a person didn't understand a little bit about spiritual things, you'd go crazy like that. You'd be standing there wondering what happened. And he said, the vision is not your end. It's for your ministry. That sword is the word.
Amen.
Oh. Like I said, if you can believe Moses and the burning bush experience, why can't you believe the seventh angel and the experience that he shared with us?
Yes. Amen.
The sword comes to my hand. Number 33, and I'm closing. I'm leaving you with this one. The true evidence, amen, of being baptized with the Holy Ghost is for the believer to receive the word for the age in which he lives.
Amen. Thank you.
God bless you. Have you received the word for the age in which you live? Have you received the revelation of his coming? God bless you, and we'll be back next week. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Only believe, brother. Only believe, sister.
Thank you, brother.
Amen.
Brother, can we just stand? And turn with me to 260 days. And we'll sing the hymn, Jesus in the Cloud. One day in 1963 in Arizona, a mystery cloud appeared in the sky. The seventh angel told us in the message, that's our Lord himself out there in the cloud. Amen.
That's what we believe.
Yes.
True. Perfect. Western Australia.
Thank you.